Hello and welcome to Alchemy 2.0, serving weekly gems from alchemy to alchemy. Still working on the jingle.
I'm Allison Stoner.
At this point, we've been COVIDing, that's a verb now, right? For nearly all of 2020. And the novelty of wild Zoom backgrounds, Tiger King binges, and Instagrammable baking bread wore off on like March 347th.
In this new normal, we're facing pressure from all sides, professional and personal, to stay productive while simultaneously staying healthy.
For me, those currently feel like conflicting goals because I'll admit, I've fallen a bit out of balance.
Help, I've fallen and I can't get up.
As lines blur between work hours and Diner Dash, and time is just a flat out liar, burnout is becoming an all too real experience and ever-present threat.
Have you noticed this?
I mean, yes, this pandemic is a marathon, not a sprint, but we're still running this marathon at 100 miles an hour. My new Zoom life coach came up with that, not me. Unsurprisingly, pushing yourself to the absolute max output is often seen as a badge of honor in our society, which heavily values achievement and tangible progress. We love sleepless nights, dark circles, and coffee in our veins.
I read a survey at 3:52 this morning, but who's counting, that said half of all employees working from home are experiencing burnout. I feel like at least similar statistics apply to essential frontline workers, students, job seekers, and really anyone whose life has been challenged by this pandemic.
Burnout doesn't always come from work. It can happen with any life responsibility or energy draining situation, parenting, finances, even personal goals.
Or like my reality, breaking up with your partner and then being quarantined together. It's a true story.
And the walls are thin.
So I'm curious, are you having more sleepless nights or experiencing anxiety, fatigue, a sense of emotional or physical distress? And are you feeling more pressure from society or from yourself?
Hey, I just texted you. Text me back.
Today we're reachable 24/7 via devices. There's constantly someone, a friend, your cousin twice removed, your micromanaging boss, or a freaking app notification pinging you around the clock, FaceTiming you on the toilet, illuminating your screen just as you manage to finally close your eyes to sleep. Because we're always able to work, respond, create, distract. That's exhausting. It's a digital deluge. Is that word deluge? And it means we're always on.
The child star is triggered.
Because if we aren't on when beckoned, we think we might get passed over, left out, judged, maybe even punished. So we make ourselves available for longer hours and spread our energy to more people, places, and tasks. We do more! More!
I've been inside way too long.
But what other factors might be driving you to burnout? Personally, I've avoided rest because I'm afraid of feeling out of control. And I'm also afraid to admit several flaws that are showing up while I'm home that I really don't want to face.
Sometimes we don't realize we're slipping until we're flat on the ground. And then it all starts piling up on us. Raise your hand if you've ever gone through a rough patch in a relationship, so you throw yourself into work or another distraction, ignoring the problem and lessons with your partner. Okay, I can't see your hand, so drop an emoji if pain and discomfort drive you to do anything other than deal with the issue, which creates more issues. Same.
How might this relate to you feeling burned out and unable to focus or center in life?
Ah, we're digging in so deep.
Hot take, or at least an unpopular one, by documenting, posting, and liking everything on social media, we're creating an outward narrative and trend at home that we ought to do more visible action, be more outwardly good, show evidence of progress, and we're curating our public self at the expense of our deeper inner true self, and that self needs to be cared for and transformed. We cannot afford to lose ourselves in the void in this interim, but how can we find balance between the hustle and health and not give in to the harmful cycles that lead to burnout? Well, I learned an exercise that helps you weigh which tasks to take on so you can be more deliberate about making time for what matters. And of course, that includes rest and personal reflection and conscious growth. Otherwise, all our devices, apps, and systems are by nature addictive, stressful, and ultimately dangerous if left unmonitored. So grab a pen and paper or phone notepad or whatever you use to write and record with, and make a list of three factors that each incoming request must check off in order for you to say yes. Otherwise, you say no to the task or ask. For example, can I complete this in less than 2 hours? Does this additional request move my mission forward? Will accepting this request support balance and self-care? Once you have your unique list for taking on requests or asks, revisit it whenever a new item or message comes in or whenever you're considering adding to your to-do list. It will free up brain space, alleviate stress, and reduce procrastination, and just help you focus on the things that matter most. I hope this tool can be helpful for you in finding balance during this time. Feel free to share your thoughts, ideas, any personal discoveries you've made in the comments below. And of course, click like, subscribe, follow if you haven't already. I'd love to have you as a part of the community here. And please share this with someone if you think it can be helpful. See you soon.
Also, feel free to make up a jingle for Alchemy 2.0.
Bye! Hey, thanks for watching. As a gift, I'm going to give you my phone number. Yes, text me and we can chat directly. 419-871-5434. Also, if you haven't already checked out my podcast, Simplexity, I dig in every week to make your life brighter and better. Did I say like, comment, subscribe?